This is a review of Oppositional Defiant Disorder and Conduct Disorder. The author is Dr. Chiang Kaman, a second-year resident of the National Psychiatry Program. The objectives of this review are to understand the prevalence, diagnostic criteria, basic management guidelines, and prognosis of Oppositional Defiant Disorder and Conduct Disorder, ODD and CD for short. The outline of this review includes the definition, epidemiology, diagnostic criteria, etiological factors, comorbidity, management guidelines, and prognosis of ODD and CD. Conduct disorder is an enduring set of antisocial and aggressive behaviors that evolves over time, usually characterized by aggression and violation of the rights of others. ODD have similar negative attributes but in a limited fashion. According to ICD-10, oppositional disorder is a subtype of conduct disorder. DSM-IV excludes oppositional disorder if a conduct disorder is present. The estimated rates of conduct disorder among the general population range from 1 to 10%, with a general population rate of approximately 5%. The disorder is more common among boys than girls, and a male-to-female ratio is 4 to 1. The prevalence rate of ODD is 1 to 16%. There are biological and psychosocial etiological factors that give rise to CD and ODD. Genetics and familial clustering is thought to be implicated in the genesis of CD and ODD. Neurotoxins and vitamin nutritional deficiency is also implicated. And in individuals with this disorder, there is a baseline hypoarousal, and there are temperamental factors involved. Under the psychosocial subheading, individuals with CD and ODD have insecure attachment, in particular the anxious avoidant type. Social learning is implicated. There is deficiency in social processing skills. Among others are poverty, community violence, lack of parental supervision, and child abuse. The DSM-IV criteria for CD is as below: a repetitive and persistent pattern of behavior in which the basic rights of others or major age-appropriate societal norms or rules are violated, as manifested by aggression to people or animals. The examples are often bullying, threatening and intimidating others, initiating physical fights, physical cruelty to people and animals, and forcing someone into sexual activities. It is also exemplified by destruction of property, deceitfulness or theft, and serious violations of rules. There are psychological treatment available for individuals with ODD or CD. Among others, they are the cognitive behavior therapy. For conduct problems in children and adolescents, typically it includes social skills training and anger management. The most common targets are aggressive behavior, social interactions, self-evaluation, and emotional dysregulation. Functional family therapy is used to address family processes such as improving communication, reducing interparental inconsistency, tightening supervision and monitoring, and negotiating rules. This method reduced reoffending rates by 50%. The target age for this therapy is 11 to 18 years, and it takes 8 to 12 hour-long sessions. and the four phases includes engagement, motivation, behavioral change, and finally, generalization. Multisystemic therapy is one of the best developed treatments of conduct disorder, which rests on 9 treatment principles. The clinician takes on only 4 to 6 cases at a time, since the work is intensive. Treatment is usually given for 3 months and then stopped. In multisystemic therapy, the young person's and family's needs are assessed in their own context at home and in their relationships with other systems such as school and peers. Following the assessment, proven methods of intervention is used to address difficulties and promote strengths. In this therapy, assessing and promoting the strengths in the young person and the system is very important. In summary, conduct disorder is an enduring set of antisocial and aggressive behaviors that evolves over time, usually characterized by aggression and violation of the rights of others. Oppositional defiant disorder have similar negative attributes, but in a limited fashion. The prevalence of ODD or CD in the general population is estimated at 1 to 10%. The genesis of these disorders are multifactorial in origin. Diagnosis is via fulfillment of criteria outlined in the DSM manual. Management of ODD or CD includes cognitive behavior therapy, functional family therapy, and multisystemic therapy. Thank you.